Hi all, how are you? I am going to do a card for one of my son's friends is having a birthday party today. I didn't actually know about it until yesterday, and of course, last night we got sidetracked, so I didn't have the opportunity to go out and get a card. So not that I would really do that anyway, but I would have probably made the card last night. So I am gonna use this is a jelly plate that I actually made. I have video up on the YouTube on my YouTube, and I think I have a link on my actually, I don't even think I even have a link on my blog because I did it when I was design team for Sin City Stamps. So in this YouTube channel, I will put a link to that in there so you guys can see it. So I'm gonna just make I'm not gonna go crazy. I'm just gonna make a quick card. I have some cards from Michaels here and see how they fit perfectly on that. It's for a boy, so it's going to be masculine colors. So we're gonna do some, let's see, we're gonna do some blue. And I always start, that's probably actually a lot more. Here, let me get you down a little. Here. I start with less, big time, because you can always go in with more, and I always tend to like put too much on there. So I'm like, I really do like the dots. And again, I did the same thing. That's way too much yellow, I mean orange. So I'm gonna pull some of that off, and I can always add it back on. So I'm gonna get, oops, my roller, and we are gonna roll and have some fun with this. Now, another thing that I'm gonna do here real quick while this is still wet is I am gonna drizzle some black paint that I have here on this. Okay, and then I'm gonna put this down. Pull it off. See, now it's a very smudgy, and that's fine with me because what we're gonna do is roll out the paint. That was literally version one because that's got a lot of black on it. So now I'm going to bring in some of the orange and press down a little harder because it should have picked up a little more paint. And that, this feels like it's going to do a much better print there. Okay, going to do a nice yellow here. More of that orange in there. Gonna okay, and you just, what's great with this is you just keep going until you get what you want. Ah, see, and now you have the black coming through. Just get the edges here. Get all the way to the end. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is go back in and do the dark blue, and I'm gonna do this very cool light blue, and I'm gonna keep a little bit of the yellow. Now I'm going to go back in with just a few of those and get the stop off drops. Just a couple that time. Okay. Okay. Now remember, this is still like really the base. There's gonna be stuff on top of this. Now, how cool is that? Very cool. And I have a piece of chipboard here. I'm gonna just roll that in there. Look at that. That's gonna be great for a different card. I think I have too much light here. I think that's the problem. Let's see. Oh yeah, there, look at that. Now I don't have that glare. Here, let me show you this one. Too much light. Not very cool. Okay, and now I'm gonna clean this up. So I have some just computer paper here, but it's a heavy duty. You never waste. Never, never, never. And just use your elbows. Get that strength on, because it will just keep coming off until you're done. And then I even use, here, I'm gonna move this out of the way. We gotta clean that up. I do clean it up. Get this black, because that will go on everything. And then it'll be on my hands. So I take the roller too. And I roll, and I roll, and I roll until all that's off. And this will be like background paper for me. So, so that's the base of the card here. I'm just gonna pause this because I don't want to edit the video. I'm gonna pause it and come back as soon as I dry it. So I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Now, while it's somewhat dry, so if I pull anything up, you'll understand. I'm gonna go in with a stencil. I just grabbed this Tim Holtz stencil because I don't want it on the whole thing, and I'm gonna use. I don't think I'm actually gonna use that because that's hard. I have these little samples that came in with the Faber-Castell, one of the kits that I bought, and I realized that I left the whip spackle open, so I'm not happy about that. And of course, I know that I bought a container of that, though I can't find it now. So, and I want to do this pretty quick. So instead of whip spackle, we are going to use light modeling paste. They're all actually pretty similar, a little bit different, similar type attitude. It really depends on the look that you're going. I like light modeling paste because it dries really quick. So does the whip spackle, so I like that. So I'm just going to go through this. And again, if the paint is not completely dry, it's going to pull some of that color up into the light modeling paste, and that's okay for me. I don't have a problem with that. So if you want it kind of perfect, make sure you wait until it dries. I'm also not using the whole stencil. I'm kind of going around here. So close this up. It off. Now, while I don't typically clean anything, I don't care if paint's all over my stencil. Obviously, you can tell that. The one thing that I will clean off is modeling paste, because when that dries, it can screw up, you know, using the stencil. So, again, I'm going to pause this just for this to dry, because you do need this to dry or it's going to smear all over. So, I'll be right back. Hi guys, I'm back. I've been kind of screwing around with an idea of what I'm gonna do with the card. I did pull out some washi tape, so and it's pretty dry. I'm going to just put a couple pieces of washi tape down here. Can you see that? Yeah. All right. Cool. I'm gonna use that one. And again, I'm just trying to pick, since this is for a teenage boy, I'm trying to pick masculine type tape. Just get something a little different on there. Okay. And this is for a birthday, so I'm thinking do some clocks here, and I have these little cog pieces. Why does this keep getting off frame? There we go. These clock pieces, something like that. I was hoping to find, I have like this thing here, but I think I'm gonna take this apart. And I'm just going to use like this piece, put the clock on there, or maybe something like that, just to give it a little surface. And where is my glue? There we go. This is in really, really bad shape. I like this E6000 glue because it's, you know, super heavy duty, and I like that. Actually, maybe I should put it like that. When I use it, whatever I glue down kind of stays down. And especially since the party's today, so what I'm doing right now, I don't want it to come apart or anything. And I know somewhere in my stash I actually have the little hands, but, you know, that concept and finding them. Two different things. I thought maybe I'd luck out and they'd be right here, but no such luck. So I have these little containers here from IKEA filled with like a bunch of my metal findings. And sometimes I try to be too organized. That's what I find, and I just kind of organize myself out of finding where I put things. So, the new year, that's going to be my new goal. Now, basically at this point, I'm gonna just do a couple other little things. I have this twine here. I'm gonna kind of make something fun with this, because again, can't be too flowery, because it's for a boy. But I just want to do something. So I'm just do something here. And for this, I'm gonna use, what glue am I gonna use? I'm gonna use my 3-in-1. Cause that's good glue too. It doesn't dry as soon as you put it down. It takes a little time. But it's, again, really heavy duty, and I like that. So, I'm just making some loops here of this, just so it's got some kind of pop factor here. I'm not going to do too much. Maybe one more. Right here. Okay. Liking that so far. Hope you guys are. Let me turn it around so you could see it. And I'm gonna do some stamping. I'm gonna pause that so I can get everything out. Be right back.